Your life will never be a straight path. I began at Fordham University as a pre-med student. I took a course called the cardiac morphogenesis. I couldn't read it, I couldn't say it, I sure couldn't pass it. So then I decided to go into pre-law, then journalism. And with no academic focus, my grades took off in their own direction. Yeah, down. I was a 1.8 GPA one semester, and the university very politely suggested that it might be better to take some time off. I was 20 years old, I was at my lowest point. And then one day, and I remember the exact day, March 27th, 1975, I was helping my mother in her beauty shop. My mother owned a beauty shop up in Mount Vernon. And there was this older woman who was considered one of the elders in the town. And I didn't know her personally, but I was looking in the mirror. And every time I looked at the mirror, I could see her behind me. And she was staring at me. She just kept looking at me. Every time I looked at her, she kept giving me these strange looks. So she finally took the dryer off her head and said something I'll never forget. First of all, she said, "Somebody give me a piece of paper. Give me a piece of paper." She said, "Young boy, I have a prophecy, a spiritual prophecy." She said, "You are going to travel the world and speak to millions of people." Now, mind you, I'm 20 years old. I'm flunked out of school. In fact, like a wise ass, I'm thinking to myself, maybe she's got something in that crystal ball about me getting back into school next fall. But maybe she was onto something, because later that summer, while working as a counselor at a YMCA camp in Connecticut, we put on a talent show for the campers. And after the show, another counselor came up to me and asked, "Have you ever thought about acting? You're good at that." So when I got back to Fordham that fall, I got in and I changed my major once again for the last time. And in the years that followed, just as that woman prophesied, I have traveled the world and I have spoken to millions of people through my movies. Millions who up till this day couldn't see me, I couldn't see while I was talking to them, and they couldn't see me. They could only see the movie. They couldn't see the real me. But I see you today, and I'm encouraged by what I see, and I'm strengthened by what I see, and I love what I see. One more page, and I'll shut up. Let me conclude with this one final point, and actually the president kind of brought it up. It has to do with the movie Philadelphia. She stole my material. Many years ago, I did this movie called Philadelphia. We filmed some of the scenes right here on campus. Philadelphia came out in 1993. Most of you were probably still in diapers. Some of the professors, too. That cracked me up. But it was a good movie. Rent it on, Netflix. It's a good movie. Rent it. I get 23 cents every time you rent it, please. Parents up there, rent it. Netflix, please. Tell your friends, too. It's about a man played by Tom Hanks who's fired from his law firm because he has AIDS. He wants to sue the firm, but no one's willing to represent him until a homophobic ambulance chaser lawyer played by yours truly takes on the case. In a way, if you watch the movie, you'll see everything I'm talking about today. You'll see what I mean about taking risk or being willing to fail. Because taking risk is not just about going for a job. It's also about knowing what you know and what you don't know. It's about being open to people and to ideas. In the course of the film, the character I play begins to take small steps, small risks. He very, very, very slowly begins to overcome his fears. And I feel ultimately his heart becomes flooded with love. And I can't think of a better message as we send you off today. To not only take risks, but to be open to life, to accept new views, and to be open to new opinions, to be willing to speak at a commencement at one of the best universities in the country, even though you're scared stiff. While it may be frightening, it will also be rewarding, because the chances you take, the people you meet, the people you love, the faith that you have, that's what's going to define you. So members of the class of 2011, this is your mission. When you leave the friendly confines of Philly, never be discouraged, never hold back, give everything you got. And when you fall throughout life, and maybe even tonight after a few mini glasses of champagne, remember this: fall forward. Congratulations, I love you, God bless you, I respect you.